Welcome back, everyone. I'm going to be talking to you guys about another species I have again this week. We're going to be talking about Priscilla prunonix, the powder isopod. In my opinion, this is the most versatile and pretty much easiest isopod that you could take care of. You could put in any bioactive setup. Pretty much anything you want to do with these guys, it's going to be super easy. These guys can thrive in any kind of environment. I would say any dry environment, any moist environment. These guys are just going to survive and breed like crazy. Now, they are probably also one of the cheapest isopods out there, so that makes them even better for both a bioactive setup and for a beginner hobbyist, I guess you could say. They are going to eat pretty much anything you throw at them. They're going to be able to just bow down on just about anything. And they're going to just multiply like crazy. So if you're someone who enjoys watching these guys run around, they are going to be out all the time. Doesn't matter if it's dark out, it doesn't matter if it's light out, these guys are just going to be around. And if you want to use it as a bioactive setup, they reproduce so quickly that doesn't matter how many your reptile would eat, they're gonna thrive. There's no way. Well, I guess if it was a really hungry animal or a fairly large animal that could handle a lot of these, I guess it could possibly eat them all. But these guys, they will bury underneath things. They're gonna run and hide, and they're super quick for the size they are. They're actually ridiculously quick. Here, I'll pick one up here and see if I can show you how quick they are. Let's reach down in here and pick up a few. See, there we go. So they are no means an extravagant isopod. These are the wild type powder blues, and I'll show you the powder orange I have in a second. There's a couple other morphs that you can get, but that are more expensive. But these ones here are super cheap, ridiculously cheap, and they're fairly quick, as you can see. They just run around like crazy. And if I show you a close-up here, if I can get them to settle down here for a second. Both these ones have molted recently, so they don't really have the powder sheen to them that some of them have, but I'll set these guys down if I can get them off here, and I'll grab one here that's got the powder color to it. There's quite a few of them. I just happen to grab some that have recently molted, but as you can see there, they kind of got a bit of a soft color change on the shell on the outside that gives them the name powder. Now, they aren't gonna climb like some isopods would. I would think that if you had plants in your bioactive setup that they would climb up on stuff, but for the most part, these guys are gonna be ground dwelling, just running around through the foliage, just hanging out, and they're just super easy, super easy. I can't stress this enough that they're one of the beginners that I started out with, and they've just been great for me. So here we have one of my powder orange containers, and as you can see, here, let me find some that I can pick up. They're super quick. And there's so many of them in here, like they just reproduce like crazy. And since I just fed them, they're out and about like no tomorrow. And as you can see there, they're also quite beautiful, kind of see-through isopod. A lot of the other morphs as well, like the whiteouts, are also see-through. And then there is also another one that's quite popular, Oreo Crumble, which is a little bit more expensive. That's the one I was talking about before, that's a little bit more pricey than the other ones. but I guess it's worth it if you you're doing it for the hobby aspect of it. You can see that one's got a bit of a powder coat to it, but again, they just run around like crazy. It's hard to capture these guys on camera due to the fact that they're just everywhere all at once. And you can, here, I'll give you a better look here. If you look along the side here where all the leaves are, they're just going nuts. There's so many of them in there. But yeah, like I said, you could house these guys in pretty much any sort of setup, any sort of situation. They're a great beginner. And you know, they don't cost that much. It's, in my opinion, the perfect isopod to start out with. You couldn't ask for a better isopod to start out with. They're even easier, in my opinion, to take care of and keep than the wild type you could find in your backyard. Sure, they're a little bit more expensive. Like, you could probably get 12 of these for like 10 Canadian dollars, depending on where you live. But like, that's even less American. I'm sure you could get some for. And so many isopod enthusiasts have these guys around. If you knew them well enough, I'm sure they could give you a few. Like, they're just, they reproduce super easy. And you're gonna have so many in no time. Like, you spend $10 on 12 of these guys, and in 2 weeks, you're gonna have double that amount, if not triple. And like I said, I guess I haven't said it yet, but they are not gonna hurt your animals. There's no way I can imagine these guys are gonna be aggressive enough to hurt any animal you put them in with. I don't think any amphibian would even stand some sort of issue with these guys. I mean, they're super skittish, but at the same time, friendly enough to be around. They're just very cautious, and it's in the sense, like, if I were to get near one, he's gonna dart off. He's gonna freak out and run like that guy just tried to do there. But for the most part, they aren't gonna be aggressive enough. Yes, they do love their protein, but so do most other species. But they're not gonna be as aggressive as the Laevis species we looked at last week in that sense. And I mean, there's not much else I can say about these guys. I'm just gonna end up sounding like a broken record due to the fact that they're just super easy to take care of. Anyway, you guys, I just thought I'd give you a real quick short video this week. These guys, there isn't too much that I can talk about. Like I said before, they're just beautiful, quick, easy start isopod. If you want lots of isopods, really quick, real cheap. And yeah, great to have around, always out and about. Like, they're never gonna be one, there's gonna be such a low chance of them being hidden and not out and around. Like, I could probably flip over these logs and there'd be lots more underneath, but like, oh, there's dozens underneath, but at the same time, there's so many up above. And the same would go for over here. I'm not gonna flip this one over because it's a bit rotten there and it's gonna fall apart and make a mess. But anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Have a great week, and I'll see you next weekend. All right, bye.